I'm Walter L. Watson, Jr. I'm a retired United States Air Force colonel, and I flew the SR-71 for almost 5 years. My earliest memories of air and space and my interest in it probably started when I was maybe somewhere between 7 and 8 years old. My father worked in a theater, and he took me to see a movie about the jet airplanes called the Hunters. It was about guys who flew the F-86 during the Korean War. When I saw those airplanes and saw those guys flying, I thought this was something I wanted to do. One of my heroes is Charles McGee. Charles McGee is a Tuskegee Airman who flew combat in not only World War II, but he flew in Korea and in Vietnam. He inspires all those around him because he persevered. Even though he didn't get the treatment that he deserved and he had earned, he did his job excellently, and he inspired all those around him to do the same. My mother said, "Hey, I'll get you books on things you like to read." And what are they? I said, "Airplanes, monsters, and space." About that same time started the beginning of the space program with the first astronauts, Alan Shepard, and et cetera. Because I was reading about them, it made it a lot more exciting for me. I only failed one course in all of my academic life, and that was a course in dynamics. And I failed that course because I did more worrying than I did studying. When I did more studying and less time worrying, the outcome was extremely different. A type of bullying was always there, almost through middle school. Because I liked science, liked doing science projects, my teachers told me, "Don't worry about them. You do the things you like and life will pay you dividends." I worked in highway construction. I didn't find that to be particularly enhancing my resume because I was at the business end of a shovel. And I must say that those kind of jobs inspired me to want to return to school and do well in my studies. The job that I did not leave off my resume was working in a theater as a projectionist. That to me was a pretty technical job, and it required me to understand something about mechanics and technology as it existed at that time. I had a unique experience in the SR-71. Brian Shule, my pilot, and I took off out of a base in England, and we flew up north toward the North Pole. We were going up there to do reconnaissance on some ships coming around the North Sea. And what I didn't realize on that particular time, it was in December, that we were gonna see in a space of less than a half hour, about 5 sunrises and sunsets. As we took off, we could see on one side of the airplane was night, on the other side of the airplane was day. And as we turned, those things reversed. And it was an odd feeling because you felt like you'd been through 5 days in about a half an hour. And all of this happened because you can move at 2,000 miles an hour. It was really unique and really had a tremendous impact on me.